What is happening, YouTube community? David back here in Sam's House with some more Satisfactory gameplay. So last time we got our coal plant fully set up and running. Off camera I realized that it wasn't quite running efficiently. That's because the Mark 1 miner is not fully capable of powering, 9 generators. So I used that normal coal node that was right by it to supplement it, and now we are running beautifully. If we come over here and look, we have a constant 675 megawatts of power, which means we can actually start getting steel production. And steel is where it starts to get real. So, one thing though that I did off camera as well, because it really wasn't that big a deal, is I unlocked the Xenobasher. I also got a lot of power shards built up, because while I said in the last video, in one of the previous videos, might have been the last one, might have been the one before, that the only things I really overclock are, the water extractors. We're going to, once we get this thing moving and grooving, and we're ready to really get our steel plant unlocked, we are actually going to be overclocking the miners for the steel plant. But, first, we need to get basic steel production. And in order to do that, we need 150 rotors, 50 modular frames. I should automate a modular frame setup as well. But, not going to do that just yet. We've been letting this run for a bit though, so we have plenty of these built up now. I'll do the production value up here for the modular frames to make sure that if I need more, I don't have to go running back and forth. Just set up a quick little craft bench. As you can see, though, we have plenty of rotors. And at first, we aren't going to be going overboard. With the refineries, foundries, we're just going to be setting things up to be nice and easy to work with. So we need 50 of these. We have almost enough. We'll just grab out another stack and that should give me enough to make 50. Plus extras. So we're going to set this up onto our automatic space bar pressure. How you doing today, though? You guys having a good day so far out there? I hope so. This quarantine is really going to make life interesting in a bit. So anyway, all we're going to do right now, though, is get basic steel production unlocked and then set up a quick and dirty little steel factory out by the coal nodes that I know roughly where they're at. And all that's going to be doing is getting me my steel ingots and steel beams being produced. Nothing more, nothing less. Alright, so we now have enough modular frames built up that that's not going to be a worry. We can get our basic steel production done. Now we're just going to build a quick sky bridge over there. That for right now we run along. In time I'll make it a vehicular one, or not vehicular, we'll do, hypertubes out there. The things that we're going to be trying for next, though, are to get, we're going to have to eventually automate these up, because I need them for the versatile frameworks, I believe. Yeah, I do, actually. So. But before we can do all that, I need to have a more consistent power generation. So, we're going to get that to a Mark II miner on that PR node. We're going to get the belts upgraded to Mark III belts. So we need to get those two things available before I can actually get moving with the next stages of the space elevator. Because I don't have the power right now, and I don't really feel like making an entire second power plant than what I've already got. What I've got should be good enough. Once I make it a Mark II miner on that pure coal node, it was handling 6 relatively well, so that means that I can probably increase to a 12 pod there without any issues. Grab another 100 of those just in case. And these should be building up nicely. I've already got all that I need. I need more wire, though. Alrighty. We're about to unlock steel production. And then I will just grab all the concrete that I've built up already and bridge my way over to where the steel is. Or where the... not steel, but you know what I mean. Okay.
Milestone reached. Steel production unlocked. Foundry grants access to new, simple steel parts. An additional project part can now be constructed. Progress to the next phase is now possible.
So we're going to want 3 of the 6 of these, actually. One for each of the nodes we're on. Because I'm going to basically set this up that it's 3 pure iron nodes to 3... Sorry. I don't think I need... Yeah, I'll need 3 to 3, won't I? For this to work right. Because I'm going to want belts that are doing 270 ore per minute. So we'll get that set up. I needed concrete. Ow. That hurt. Okay. That gets me all the concrete I'll need. Hopefully. I'd hate to have to run back and forth before even getting out to the coal nodes. I'm doing this like this, by the way, so that way everything stays onto the same grid, at least roughly. Ow. Oh, now I need to heal back up. Okay. At least one of those nodes is a pure iron node, I know. Possibly both of them. Actually, no, one of them's only an MPR. Thank you. kind of see the coal node over there, too. That's where I'm building my way towards. Now you can really see the coal node over there. So yeah, I'm doing the foundations like this, that way everything stays on the same grid, though. So that's a pure iron node down there, I believe. These three coal nodes right here that I'm building to are all normals, but that's okay. That's a pure node down there. In fact, while we are at it, logistics. I should have brought my brought more stuff with me. Whoops. That we do still have to run back. You can see the three coal nodes right here. Can't quite see it to aim at it though. Okay. I don't really care so much if the miners are on the grid, because I can get the snap-ins well easily enough by just using wall mounts. But I want everything else to be on the grid. And then what we will do is walls. I'll need to go grab more planks. Alright. So we now have this built up, which is nice. Once we're back onto the straightaway, I can do the quick little shuffle step to speed my way along. I don't know if this is actually faster or not, but since I haven't unlocked all the stuff for Caterium to get my Blade Runners yet. Alrighty. So basically what I am going to do is each and every one of those miners is going to get brought into a wall opening, a single one, which will let me sort them out as I need to. And then we're just going to quickly build up a cheeky little starter factory area for the steel. It's not going to be anything big. Just enough to get me some basic steel pipe or steel beam production and steel pipe production going. Four. Which with three normal nodes is going to be 180, which divided by 45 is going to be four total foundries, which means I have two producing steel beams, two producing steel pipes. me a decent stockpile quickly. And then I just need that 180 again from my other miners for iron to make this balance out. If I do actually make this a road, I will actually elevate it just a little bit to get it over that kind of hump thing right there. But for right now, we can just go ahead and do this nice and easy. So I will have to do some searching for the other pure nodes. I'm fairly certain that's a pure. Let me just double check it. That would be hyper embarrassing if it was not. Right? Yeah, that's the pier. Okay. Then underneath this little piece right here is another power slug, which I'm going to go pick up. Okay. So we need find at least one more pure node, which I think this one over here is pure, and then I will want one more pure as well. That is copper. Direction. Let's see what you are. Yeah, that copper is definitely not what I wanted, though. You're pure. Let's go ahead and pick up that carapace. Put down my miner on you, facing in roughly the right direction, and we're actually going to drag this thing on back for now. And I'll do another scan here in a second for the iron nodes again. Iron. Yeah, 100 meters that way. I think that one's an impure, though. But let's find out. Once I have all of them built up, I'm going to get all the belts all nice and neatly arranged. So that one's definitely impure. Right? Yeah. We're going to go 100 more meters this direction and figure it out. That one should be a pure one over here. Yep, okay. I want the pure ones because that when I upgrade the belts, that will allow me to get my 6 pieces out of it. Or get everything I need out of these without having to worry about it. Okay, well, let's just go ahead and drag this on back for now, then. If it clips through the ground, that's fine. This one definitely is going to take a bit to get on out, but we'll get it there. There probably was a pure node closer that I could have used, but whatever. I'm doing this with the wrong belts too, so I'm going to have to go back through and fix that. But that's an easy thing to fix. So then basically what we're going to do is we'll drag all of these around to their various places that they need to be at. And meet up all the belts at the appropriate places. Sounds like a plan? Sounds like a plan. First of all, we're just going to bring our coal lines on up here. More walls, please. 9. Alright, we have our coal belts brought on up. Now we have to get all of our iron belts on up, which is going to be a trial and a half, I can tell you already, just to get them all relatively to the same spot. Weird as hell. I don't know if you can see where I'd put that thing at. Can't afford. Let's do it with this one then. Okay, that's two of my iron lines brought on in. Now we just have to figure out how we're going to get this last one brought on over. Okay.
please. Mark to your left. Mark to your belt. And we'll do it through a wall as well. Bada bing, bada boom, bada bam. And now we can drag this back on over. So we've got way more iron than we need right now. So that's to the good. Still figure out how exactly I'm going to make all this work. Okay. So we've got three iron lines coming in. They'll each be coming in at 120. We've got three coal lines coming in. They will each be coming in at 60 for right now. Let me go back down then. So 60 times 3 is 180. Which means we can split this up into four total foundries. With a little bit of load balancing here. So what I will probably do is split this one between the two belts. And then I think, which might be a good idea here, is if we go like that, and like that, and bring the iron up and drop it on in. Seems like a good idea to me. Yep, okay. That's what we're going to do. Just like that. Bada bing, bada boom, bada bam. And then I need to go grab more iron plates, so we'll go grab that. When we come back on out here, we'll be with everything we need. But yeah, then I will combine. Put this belt into the two, so that way it goes 90-90. And then split those 90 belts into 45s to get it to work right. For right now, this belt's not actually even needed, because I'll have 240 from those two alone. Which will just overflow method into it for the iron, because we're going to be way overproducing on iron anyway. Actually, if I leave that one belt at the third, at the 60, that's 180, which we can overflow properly, which we could do the splits off, split it once, split it twice, 90. That would actually work, wouldn't it? Split 30 off of that one as soon as it's up top, and then just drop them down 90-90. Yeah, I like that idea. So that's what we're going to do for now. I need to go get cabling as well, so that way I can drag the power along. And when we come back on out, that is exactly what we will do, is drag power back with us as well. Then run power to each of those miners. And get a foundry set up that's producing steel. There'll be four foundries to four constructors. With the appropriate splits. One foundry basically will be responsible for nothing but steel beams. Or steel pipes, I mean. It'll split into two.
And then the other three foundries will get a weird split between them to get the other two, right? No. Messing something up there. Anyway. Oh, right. It'll be one foundry pumping out, or one constructor pumping out, I need, it should be a 2 and 2. I'll have to do the math on it. Cable, please. And thank you. I should set up a cable factory too. Been playing for 8 hours now. This is definitely not my speedrun build. Speedrun, I was already well past this point. Couple hundred cables should be fine though. And we'll grab some more plates and run back on out. We have plenty of rods. Okay. But we do need more plates. And we still have plenty of concrete, so we shouldn't need any more of that anytime soon. Okay, we'll grab those plates. Start dragging power out. What I'm actually going to do is, because I am eventually going to want to probably put a hypertube entrance up here. I don't know if I'll do want to do it at the main base or out here. I'm leaving the capability for me to do it out here. Max is at. Yep. And try to have this thing actually line up that this breakout is right by that miner. At least close enough to it, that will be fine. And then you should just finish off right about at this corner piece. And we have power. Okay. So, now then. We need to put up a splitter right there. And then we're going to put up a merger right there and right there. I know that most of this is going to have to get broken down. But by doing that, are now both 90 lines, which I can then drag out here where needed and split them off into 45 lines. And you see that actually fits up beautifully with that. Okay, I want a regular wall there though. Okay, now then, what we need to do is also, though, I need to get myself the capability to go on up. So we'll build that right there to just sneak our way on up. I was hoping that was going to work, but it didn't quite. Now instead, what we'll do is like that. So that should quite work. So just around to there. Okay. So now we have the capability, and what we're going to do is which one of these. Mark 2 all the way up, I wonder. You are Mark 2 all the way up into that one, so into that one. Okay. So what we're going to do is immediately split this. Another merger. Right there. So now that 120 line is getting split three ways, right? Makes this one a 60 line again, and this one a 60 line, and this one a 60 line. Wait, is that what I wanted to do? One was already going to be a 60, so that's now a 90. See, I'm trying to just take... No, wait, that's not right. 120 divided by 3 is 40 a pop. So that's 100. Damn, that's not going to work. Okay. Never mind, then. We'll just make the Mark II belts all the way on out. Both of them, and we'll overflow it. Okay. So, foundries. What we are going to be trying to do here is one. Of each of these. Alrighty.
steel line done. You will shut off like so, and then you just take in directly from that merger. Okay, that is my coal lines done for that. Now I just need to get my... And this is why I set it up like this. Is now I can just go boop, 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 and... Wait, why did you not line up right? You annoying piece of shit. The other one... Nope, never mind, they didn't all line up right. Okay. We have to do some rework here then. One second. Okay. Okay, so this first one definitely is lined up, right? So, next up. Production. Foundry. Okay, so you can't quite fit them both like that. You have to leave one gap if you want to do it that way. Okay, good to know. One, two. Break that down for now. Break that down for now, because I'll be able to bring that back on out once I know where I can place it at. Three. And... Four. Alrighty. Solid walls here. Okay. Alrighty. Do the same thing on this one as well, so it's for sure the 90. Which I hate not having this thing be 90s. Okay. And then we repeat the project over here. Too far. Okay, we'll do it this way then. stealing it, please. And thank you. Okay, so this is going to be 90 per minute between you two. Right? So it's 180 total per minute. So basically what I would need to do is production constructor. Fuck you and your floor, just keep bullshit. Constructor, please. The reason for this would be is I would do it like this. Then off of here. I would do a splitter, which will make this one actually come up to, if you're producing 45 per minute out of here. That extra I have to do it like this though for this one. Okay. This is where I have to do it like this. And now it works right. So this one now is producing my, so I have 15 going in each direction. So that's 30 out of this one now, which will go nicely into the next constructor. Break you down real quick because I want to put you down one more row. And I'm going to need to run back and grab more concrete. Unfortunate. But what we can do now is let's get you lined up with. Actually, you're still only taking 60 per minute, so you can line up like that. You will be steel beams, you will be steel pipes, and we'll just repeat that same thing down there on the other one as well. Let's find one somewhere in here that I can get rid of safely. I will keep that one up for now. But that one can go. So now we repeat that process. Conveyor merger. Conveyor splitter. Conveyor merger. And now we can just go constructor. Constructor. I did not put that up right. Okay, so that still is thinking to the wrong one there. Beams. You are going to be steel pipes. Okay. I think now I am ready to start thinking about hooking this up. I have hopefully enough concrete to do this without having to disassemble more stuff. You know what, let's just take down some of these walls as well, so that way I for sure have that room. That one's going to be where I start feeding my stuff back for the miners. Back to here real quickly. I need one to come down here to these miners. Okay. Coal miners are online. Now we'll come over this way a little bit. I'll have to do some work with this. But I should be able to hit that iron miner at least. Damn, I'll have to figure out how I'm going to get down from here. We'll break those down for now. And we will do the Fortnite style for a little bit. And we're on the ground. See how easy that was. Okay. Now we'll come around here, hook up the iron miner, please. Wire is too long still. Okay. And then have to be careful that I don't walk too close to those jackasses, because I'm doing this weird. And then we'll hook up this one. I'll go back along here and make sure that this belt is entirely at the, appropriate speed. It was not. Okay. That gets me my, steel beams and steel pipes in production once things get moving. So the first of the steel stuff should already be in production now. Because I had this split up. Oh god, that. Okay. That's annoying is what that is. But yeah, the first of the steel stuff should already be in production. And then the rest of it will come up here shortly, I feel like. Or did I mess something up here? I totally forgot to do something up here. Just for right now to get it hooked up. And that should definitely not be that one. That should be that one. No, wait, that should be that one. Shit. That should be that one. Okay. Alrighty. We're good again. I'm going to have to clean this up a little bit, but now at least some of my steel is in production. I can go back down and grab more concrete now and call it good. Then we'll come back down here and put out buffer boxes. Or storage boxes. They're not really buffer boxes, are they? To store up couple hundred of each. And then we'll be able to do the advanced steel production and, after that, hypertubes. As well as logistics Mark III. Once we get the advanced steel production online, though, and we can build the, Mark II miners, we get more power capability. Which will be nice, because we are definitely approaching our limits here. As you can see. But we're going to end this episode here. All I'm going to do off camera is build up a buffer box and then let this run for a little bit. While I go and go to sleep for a while. I'm getting tired. If you like, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. And yeah, let me know if you want to see something special in the next video. Till the next time, take care.